Woodstock Music Festival began on August 15, 1969. Taking place on a dairy farm in Bethel, New York, the three-day festival had 500,000 people in attendance, and eventually, Woodstock became representative of the counterculture movement of the 1960s. A total of 32 local and world-renowned musicians and bands performed at Woodstock, including Jimi Hendrix, The Grateful Dead, and Carlos Santana. However, among those that did not perform was Bob Dylan, even though the event took place near his house. In fact, Dylan left to perform in England on the day the festival began. Hello, my name is Jack, and I'm your host for this episode of HC60, Hippies, Counterculture, and the 1960s. Today I'm joined by Alex and Xiaofeng, and we will be discussing the 1969 Woodstock Music Festival and the implications of Bob Dylan's absence. Before we begin, let's take a moment to acknowledge our sponsor for this video, Woodstock Music and Arts Fair 2019. Celebrate Woodstock's 50th anniversary during a three-day music event in Watkins Glen, New York, August 16th through the 18th. Some of the world's best jam and psych rock bands will be there, so get ready for the best party since 1969. So let's dive right in. We all know Woodstock and its importance to the development of counterculture, as well as Bob Dylan's typical anti-war persona. But let's dig a little deeper into Bob Dylan's relationship to the Woodstock Festival of 69. Starting with Woodstock expert and number one Chinese hippie Xiaofeng, we have our first question. Some people say that the music festival is named Woodstock, despite taking place in Bethel, New York, to attract Bob Dylan, who was living in Woodstock at the time. Do you agree with this theory?
Partially, the investment group which helps fund the concerts was named Woodstock Venture, which is the more likely reason behind the name. But I think Dylan definitely had a pivotal part in the development of the city of Woodstock, and these developments influenced the name of the concert. Woodstock was originally a small, simple town with only about 3,000 residents year-round and 20,000 in the summer. And it may have only remained this way if Dylan hadn't had his motorcycle accident in Woodstock's Wooded Hill in 1966. No ambulance was called, he didn't visit a hospital, and there was no police record of the accident. Rumors drew people's attention to Dylan's injury and to the small town of Woodstock. For the next several years, Dylan disappeared from the public's eyes. During this time, Dylan recorded more than 100 demo songs, including The Mighty Queen, All Along the Watchtower, and These Wheels on Fire. It is Dylan's shadowy presence which turns Woodstock into a musical hub. Woodstock became a place where musicians who dream of being close to Bob Dylan congregated. The town would become a gathering place for some of the biggest names in rock at the time. Inspired by the musical fame of Woodstock, the organizers decided to name the festival Woodstock as the marketing strategy to attract the artists of Woodstock, such as Bob Dylan.
For our second question, we have actual Woodstock attendee, Alex. So, what may be the significance of Bob Dylan not attending the event, even though it took place near where he resided?
So it's interesting to note that Dylan's excuse for not attending the event was that his child was sick. However, he left to perform in England the same day Woodstock began, which immediately invalidates his reason for his absence. There were rumors that Dylan was annoyed by the hippies gathering around his house due to Woodstock. In fact, shortly after, Dylan moved to Greenwich Village, complaining that his house was surrounded by whom he called druggies. Some of Bob Dylan's music represented the hippie movement, and many of those in the community considered Dylan to be an icon. However, in chapter 3, page 115 in Dylan's Chronicles, he claims, quote unquote, "The world was absurd. I had very little in common with and knew even less about a generation that I was supposed to be the voice of." And he even stated later on in page 117 that he wanted to set fire to the hippies surrounding his house when he was complaining about the quote-unquote goons and creeps that would constantly, you know, storm his house and annoy his family. And finally, on page 116, he says, "Roadmaps to our homestead must have been posted in all 50 states for gangs of dropouts and druggies." So going back to the question, I think Dylan's situation demonstrates the complexities of being an artist. One of the main roles of a musician or an artist, especially in the 20th century, was to express one's individuality and to trigger a reaction in the public. You know, on one hand, Dylan writes his songs to convey many of his ideas, and, you know, he wrote protest songs and many songs discussing his intimate relationships. However, his expression and freedom came at a price, and he unintentionally attracted a group that he was unwilling to represent. This is demonstrated again on page 120 of Chronicles, where he states, quote-unquote, "I was sick of the way my lyrics had been extrapolated, their meaning subverted into polemics, and that I had been anointed as the big Bubba of rebellion." So, as a result, he really saw Woodstock as an event that embodied the hippie community, and as a result, this perspective drove him not to attend.
Going back to Xiaofeng for question 3, how does Bob Dylan's absence at Woodstock reveal his change in attitude toward the dichotomy between his personal and public life?
After the motorcycle accident, Dylan revealed that the crash left him with a cracked vertebra and serious cuts and bruises. For the singer, the recovery time presented an almost life-saving chance to escape the pressures of his world, to disappear into the bosom of family life, exchanging his brutal schedule of constant album releases and studio time for time with his wife Sarah and their children. As Dylan retreated into his domestic life, Dylan might realize that he was not only an acerbic protester, but also a husband and father for his wife and his three children. In his memoir Chronicles, he wrote, "I had been in a motorcycle accident, I had been hurt, but I recovered. Truth was that I wanted to get out of the rat race. Having children changed my life and segregated me from just about everybody and everything that was going on. Outside of my family, nothing held any real interest for me, and I was seeing everything through different glasses." After all, as mentioned before, Dylan's first reason in not attending Woodstock was that one of his children fell ill and needed to be taken care of.
Back to our resident grandpa here, Mr. Alex, for the fourth question. Although he missed Woodstock 69, Bob Dylan made his long-awaited Woodstock debut during the festival's 1994 incarnation. What changed that prompted Bob Dylan to make his iconic appearance at that very muddy event?
Woodstock 1969 would represent a high watermark for the hippie generation. However, the 1969 event would act as a swan song for the 60s counterculture. The slow death of the Vietnam War, the fall of the Haight-Ashbury in San Francisco, and the chaos of the Altamont Music Festival were collectively the death knell for the movement. Within 5 years' time, the hippie movement had all but been extinguished, falling into obscurity. By 1994, hippies were nothing more than a historical anecdote. Hippies, as they had once existed during the Summer of Love, did not exist, and any self-proclaimed hippies were merely emulating what they were before. The raucous, uncontrolled chaos of the 60s counterculture embroiled hippies did not nearly resemble the crowd of Woodstock 94. Dylan was playing to a different group of people than those that pestered him outside his Newark home 25 years earlier. Because the hippie movement had long been dead, and the potential for a hefty paycheck was evident, Dylan's reasoning for his appearance at the event is, I think, rather obvious.
"Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. I'm not sleepy and there is no place I'm going to."
Thank you, Alex. Bob Dylan is often confused to be a voice of the counterculture movement, so much so that many considered him to be an icon. However, Dylan's absence in Woodstock and his complaints of "those damn hippies" reveals a completely different perspective. We've often praised Dylan for his surreal and poetic lyrical composition, however, that doesn't stop folks from misinterpreting the true meaning behind his words. Ironically, Even though Dylan may have represented the common folk, his lyrics and music are only truly understood by certain people. He self-admits to this fact.
I am ready to go anywhere. I'm ready for to fade into my own parade. Cast your dance and spill my way.
Aha! This concludes our stellar 60s Power Hour. Thank you to our wonderful guests, Alex and Xiaofeng.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
And thank you to our wonderful listeners and interstellar space cadets for joining us on this episode of HC60 on this totally tubular afternoon. Adios, compadres.